You assume that the title of Sam Smith's long-awaited second album, The Thrill of It All, is a slightly weary one, weighing up the emotional cost of partying. Smith said as much on the BBC the other night. Actual thrills are scarce on these 10 tracks, which fulfill the brief of following up a hit album with a bankable sequel. These are songs dealing with heartbreak, coming out in the parlous state of the world in time-honored, mainstream fashion by making the sound so palatable that any real sense of suffering is lost. The blame falls unequally. Smith's bruise of a voice is not particularly at fault here. He quavers like a champ, swapping falsetto for tenor and back again. This is why we pay Smith, and even with his new physique he delivers. The first track written for this album, Him, is all minorkey reverberation. It plays on the word him, a hymn of sorts that addresses God, but reveals a coming-out drama. Smith's vocal runs the gamut from vulnerable to righteous. Pray finds Smith struggling with agnosticism but resorting to more gospel choirs, but this music is ever so easy on the ear. Gospel choirs are called into service to add gravitas elsewhere, the Dap King horns are on speed dial. One last song summons up the ghost of Smith's unrequited love, the subject of In the Lonely Hour, for a brief encore. But Smith does it by harking back to the overtidy melodic resolutions of classic Motown, and no inkling that we have more color palettes available now than just warm beige. Did Kanye release 808s and Heartbreak for nothing? You can count this album's quirks on two fingers. There's a slightly sinister pitch shift to the backing vocals on Say It First, a pleasant tune about who should take the three-word plunge and say I love you first. Pray, Smith's reaction to a trip to Iraq, pairs him with 90s sonic mischief maker Timbaland. It finds Smith struggling with agnosticism but resorting to more gospel choirs in the face of the world's suffering, while the producer tries to smuggle in some muted electronic squiggles under a predictable sequence of piano chords. Burning by Sam Smith, Live from Hackney Round Chapel, from the Thrill of It All. There is little drama here, just plenty of shorthand sad pianos, a total absence of risk and, perhaps worst of all, no evidence of the deranged hedonism that catapulted Smith into a funk. He could have asked Disclosure, the authors of his breakthrough feature Latch, or even Naughty Boy credited here to capture the reckless abandon of being a newly single 20-something again with a sideboard full of Grammys and nightclubs at his feet. Say It First does have a discreet aortal lub-dub of a beat, and Baby, You Make Me Crazy hints at carnage. I would do anything to get you off my mind, but the song's retro filter mutes any actual derangement. Ultimately, Adele, pop's risk avoider-in-chief, sold umpteen more copies of 25 than West did of 808s and Heartbreak. Why would any pop star in the right mind ever take a sonic risk, when the rewards for Moping by Numbers are so vast? For all his protestations to the contrary on Baby, You Make Me Crazy, Smith is very sane.